In this screencast, we'll apply certain boundary conditions to the simplified version of the Navier-Stokes equation to produce a velocity profile. So if you take a look here, we actually have two velocity profiles between two parallel plates. So this first top velocity profile is parabolic in nature, which means that it is pressure-driven flow. Therefore, the top plate needs to be stationary. If we look down here, note that the velocity of the fluid is going to the left. Due to the no-slip condition, that means that the plate that the fluid is attached to also has to go to the left. So here, we're going to look at a specific type of flow and determine its velocity profile. So this is what's known as Quetta flow. Again, it's steady state, one-dimensional, incompressible flow. You have two horizontal, infinite parallel plates. Here, the top plate is moving at a velocity. So here we'll draw the top plate, and it's moving at a velocity u. The bottom plate here is stationary, and we're going to be looking here in the y direction. We're going to call this 0, and then the distance between the two plates is going to be h. And so now we need that velocity profile, in other words, u as a function of y, for this Couette flow. So let's start by writing the general simplified Navier-Stokes equation for any kind of steady state, one-dimensional flow, two horizontal, infinite parallel plates. And that's going to be that our u of y is equal to 1 divided by 2 times the viscosity of the fluid, dp dx, which is the pressure gradient, times y squared, plus c1 times y plus c2. And as I said, this is a generalized simplification, and what makes it specific for our particular type of flow are the boundary conditions that we're going to use to solve for C1 and C2. So let's start with our first boundary, which is at y equals 0. So at y equals 0, because the plate is stationary, we know that the velocity of the fluid is going to be 0. Our other boundary is at h. So at y equals h, the fluid particles that are attached to that top plate have the velocity of the top plate. In this case, that's going to be equal to u. So we're going to start with that first boundary condition at y equals 0. So we're going to replace every little u in there with 0 and every y in there with 0. And what we end up with is that 0 equals 0 plus 0 plus C2. And therefore, our C2 is going to be equal to 0. Now we're going to do the same thing for the second boundary condition. So we replace u of y with u. So this is equal to 1 divided by 2 mu dp dx. And now we replace the y squared with h squared plus c1, replace the y with h, and then c2 is 0. And so now what we can do is we can rearrange and find that constant. So our C1 is going to be equal to minus 1 over 2 mu dp dx times h squared, all divided by h, plus u over h. And now we go back to our original equation right here, and we replace our C1 with the value that we just calculated. And that gives us our final velocity profile, U of Y, and that's going to be equal to 1 over 2 mu dp dx y squared minus h times y plus u y divided by h. So we can apply this at any y to determine the velocity at that point. So note if the pressure is constant, the pressure gradient here is zero, which makes this entire term zero. And so what we're left with is that u of y is equal to this final term that I'm going to write big U divided by h times y, which is linear.